السلام عليكم.
السلام.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. هيا للسلام. هيا للسلام. هيا للفلاح. هيا للفلاح. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. الحمد لله وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفؤا أحد. أحمده تعالى وأستهديه وأستغفره وأعوذ به سبحانه من سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله تعالى فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على سيدنا محمد سيد ولد عدنان، من بعثه الله رحمة للعالمين، هاديا ومبشرا ونذيرا، وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه، وسراجا وهاجا وقمرا منيرا. فهدى الله به الأمة، وكشف به عنها الغمة، وبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فجزاه الله عنا خير ما جزى نبيا من أنبيائه. أما بعد، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله العلي العظيم، القائل في محكم التنزيل: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. I praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise the rank and status and the honor of our great master and honorable prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah bestow his blessings upon him and upon every messenger he has sent and grant them peace. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who guided us to be upon the religion of Al-Islam, upon the guidance of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I remind you and I remind myself with the issue of at-taqwa, which is to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is by performing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made obligatory upon you and refraining from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited. And among the first obligations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made obligatory upon us is to worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and to know Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to us in the Qur'an how to do that and what is the way to reach the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the knowledge about Allah, which is to know that there is no God except Allah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Qur'an, فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله، واستغفر لذنبك وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات. Which means, know, O Muhammad, that there is no God except Allah. And then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness for yourself and for the believers, males and females. By this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to know that there is no God except Allah. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam already knew that there is no God except Allah. Rather, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him with this command to show the honor of the knowledge and to teach us how to know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how to know that there is no God except Allah, and that is by learning. And learning is only learning from a qualified teacher. Because we want to learn the meaning of La ilaha illallah as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught it to his companions. And the way to do that is to learn from a person who learned from a person who learned from a person all the way back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the scholars of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah for the past 1400 years have been on one belief, which is that there is no God except Allah and all the meanings that come with that word. And the scholars of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah in these 1400 years have been writing books about the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and always keeping the knowledge of the belief, what the believer is supposed to believe about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the priority. And that is also indicated in the verse that I mentioned. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, first with knowing that there is no God except Allah, which relates to the matters of the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the faith. And then he asked Prophet Muhammad, or commanded Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to seek forgiveness for himself and for the believers, which relates to the acts of worship. As we mentioned, the scholars of Islam have written many books about the belief and what to believe about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the qualified scholars of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, who their chain reaches back to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from which whom we want to learn the knowledge of the creed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with His mercy, has not made anything obligatory on His servant that His servant cannot handle or is not in his ability. Learning the matters of the creed, the scholars of Islam have summarized it and made it very easy for the common people and written detailed books about the creed for the students of the knowledge. And this creed is very simple, to the fact that some of the books that were written in the creed of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah were only one page or two pages. And this creed is very simple, and it is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exists, and that He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one with no partners, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala has no like or similar or equal to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. As he said in the Qur'an, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. There is absolutely nothing like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing equal to Him, nothing similar to Him. And He is the all-hearing and the all-seeing. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the heavens and the earth. The creator of the life and death, the creator of obedience and disobedience, the creator of health and illness. He is the one, subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created this universe and everything in it. And he is the creator of all the creations and their actions. And he is, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who determines their sustenance. Nothing in this world happens. Nothing at all happens without his will and his decree. And that he is, subhanahu wa ta'ala, attributed with life. And his life is not like our life, as we mentioned. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. Nothing is like him. His life does not have a beginning or an end. He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is eternal. He has no beginning and he has no end. He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is attributed with knowledge. And his knowledge encompasses everything. He knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything that was in the past. And he knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything that's in the present that is happening right now. And he knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything that's going to be in the future. And even those matters that will not be in the future, he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, knows if they were to be how they would be. And he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is attributed with will and power. He has power over everything. And he is attributed with speech. And his speech is not like our speech. It does not contain sound or letter. His speech, subhanahu wa ta'ala, does not have a sound and does not pause and continue like our speech. He is attributed, subhanahu wa ta'ala, with hearing. And he hears everything that is hearable. He does not need an ear or an instrument, and he hears everything. Rather, it's far or near, it's the same to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, exists without a place. And he sees everything that is seeable. Without an eye, his sight is not like our sight. He sees everything, near or far, the same to him, because he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, again, exists without a place. He knows everything that is hidden and every secret. And he is the creator of everything. And he is not in need of anyone, and everyone is in need of him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, sent to us his honorable messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to guide us and to complete our life with that which will benefit it, and the hereafter with that which will benefit us then. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has aided him with clear miracles. And everything that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam conveys from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the truth. Like the question of the angels in the grave, and the enjoyment and the torture of the grave, and the bridge in the hereafter, and the barzakh, the light between this dunya and the hereafter. And the hawd, the pool of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the balance which our deeds will be weighed in. And the jannah, the paradise, and an-nar, the hellfire. All of this that he came with sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the truth. And by this, you can summarize all the belief of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. The belief that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was upon. The belief that the companions learned from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and taught to their followers until it reached to us today. From those scholars who are connected to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was always the case between our time and the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that the first thing that a person learns are these matters of the creed that I just mentioned. To know what is obligatory to attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to know what is permissible and possible to mention about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and what is impossible to describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with. And this is how a person refrains from the hellfire. This is how a person knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worships Him. Before praying and before any acts of worship, your acts of worship are not acceptable unless if you know the one you are worshiping. And this was the creed that Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah were upon. And this is what every Muslim would think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the past 1400 years. Until the last few hundred years, when a group of deviants appeared and skipped learning this knowledge the way it's supposed to be learned from the qualified teachers who learned it from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and came up with matters in the creed that are strange, something that was never heard of before, to be in the name of Islam. They came and started innovating in the creed of Islam and calling the people to it in the name of Islam. And the religion of Islam and Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah is clear from them. They have no shame from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They attribute Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with attributes that are the attributes of the creation. This is insulting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the hadith, شَتَمَنِي عَبْدِي وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ ذَلِكَ. My servant has insulted me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about His creation. My servant has insulted me. And he insulted me by saying that I had a son, which is an attribute of a creation. And any other attribute of creations that is added to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is insulting Allah and is exiting the religion of Islam. If you look at their books and what they teach, it is something very disgusting and very dangerous and should not be accepted, to the point where they describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with limbs, and they describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with body, and they describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sitting and moving and direction. And alhamdulillah, Allah blessed us in this masjid to be protected from such evil, because we learn and we teach لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. We teach to negate everything that does not befit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then we say وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ, and He is the all-hearing and all-seeing. We attribute to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala only what befits Him. If you read in their books, they say, one of their scholars, in the name of Islam, and Islam is clear from them, they say when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sits on his throne, and he is clear from that subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not just that, they say that when he sits on his throne shakes, and you hear noises, vibrating noises from the throne. As if you put on the throne a large amount of stones. They likened Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the stones. Do they think they're worshipping an idol? Do they not know that they're worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is clear from His creation? Do they not have brains to think with, attributing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the attributes of His creation? That is because they did not learn how to think. And we, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, always taught the first thing, what to attribute to Allah and what not to. This is the most important matter. Because this strange matter that I am talking about, there is even a matter stranger than that. Which is that the Muslims today have accepted these people and have came with the ideology that it's a difference of opinion. And we understand the verse this way and they understand it that way. Which is not true. That's why the scholars have written specific books in showing you the matters that would put you outside the religion of Islam. By accepting them, you have joined them. And they, if they remain on that belief, they will not survive the hellfire and they will everlast in it. They are not worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they do not know Him. They are only worshipping something that they imagine in their minds. And I swear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that these people that I am talking about are more dangerous in the matters of the creed than the Jews and the Christians. They fabricate in the religion and teach the common people what is disbelieving in Allah in the name of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify the nation of Muhammad from them. And I call you and I warn you from accepting them. I warn you from learning from them, from sitting with them in the circles of knowledge, because they are misguiding you, and they are the ones who the Prophet ﷺ said about, that they are standing on the gates of the hellfire, calling the people to it. Whoever answers them and accepts them, they throw him into the hellfire. And if you want to prevent yourselves and protect yourselves from the hellfire, then protect yourselves from such people and learn the knowledge of the creed and what to believe about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from those who are qualified to teach it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach us what will benefit us and teach us what will make us survive in the hereafter and benefit us in that which He taught us and increase our knowledge. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast on the creed of Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast under the guidance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength and aid us to spread this belief in a time where people are spreading disbelief in the name of Islam. وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد طه الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله العلي العظيم. We spoke about the first part of the verse, which is to know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after you learn the matters of the creed and the belief, comes the second part, which is to worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is included in the first matter that is obligatory upon us. After I know who I'm worshipping, then I must worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala as He created me only to worship Him. And that includes as well learning and acquiring knowledge to know how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way that is valid. What is haram? What is prohibited? What is that I should refrain from? What is obligatory? What are those matters that I must perform? What is kufr? What is disbelief? You need to learn what is disbelief to protect yourself from it. After you learn what to believe about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you must learn what will put you outside of Islam to prevent it. Because the one who does not know what evil is more likely to fall into it. And all of this together, the knowledge of the creed and the belief, and the knowledge of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is obligatory, the obligatory matters of that, is all called the obligatory knowledge, and it is named like that because every Muslim is obligated to learn it. That does not mean to just come and sit in class and listen to the teacher. It means to learn it, understand it, apply it, and teach it to those who do not know it. And alhamdulillah, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who guided us to know this and put us in a place where this knowledge is taught. And not just taught, but taught from the qualified teachers that we spoke about. The teachers who are connected to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The teachers who learned from those who learned from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded you with a great command. He commanded you subhanahu wa ta'ala to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow His blessings on Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Which means, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and bestows His blessings on Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the angels as well ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow His blessings on Prophet Muhammad. O you who believe, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bestow His blessings on Prophet Muhammad and to grant him peace. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim wa barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma ighfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب للدعوات. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم إنك عفو غفور تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم يا مثبت القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واستغفروه يغفر لكم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
Put your heels on the line and straighten your ranks. Do not start another rank unless you finish the last one. Finish the rank. Correct your intentions for Salat al-Jumu'ah. Allahu Akbar. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، ملك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا، واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ كنتم أعداء فألف بين قلوبكم فأصبحتم بنعمته إخوانا وكنتم على شفا حفرة من النار فأنقذكم منها، كذلك يبين الله لكم آياته لعلكم تهتدون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، ملك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر وأولئك هم المفلحون. ولا تكونوا كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا من بعد ما جاءهم البينات وأولئك لهم عذاب عظيم. يوم تبيض وجوه وتسود وجوه، فأما الذين اسودت وجوههم أكفرتم بعد إيمانكم فذوقوا العذاب بما كنتم تكفرون. وأما الذين ابيضت وجوههم ففي رحمة الله هم فيها خالدون. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.